he doesn't.
Yeah, he's like just chilling.
He's a little more natural.
That's too funny. Rewind, see that ass one more time. And I got this soda, Remy boys that know it. Fast money don't slow. Cameras out.
Yeah.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. It's your boy Malik, back with another banger. Yay, yay! Today's video, as you can tell by the title, man, we are here. Hold on.
We are at Critter Lane Petting Zoo. I found out about this place through one of my videographers, Joe.
Shout out to him. But yeah, learned about this place through him. So he has like a nonprofit ordeal, and he gets to come here with the kids that he does the nonprofit for, and they get to check out this cool, amazing place. As you guys know, I love animals, and so he was like, you need to come and check that place out. So we are currently here, about to go in here and check out what it is. So a little quick synopsis, though. It is a petting zoo, and I'm like all over the place. It's a petting zoo, and yeah, it's raining today, so hopefully we still get to do what we're doing, or else this is a wasted hour trip. And I would have to go back and have to reschedule and all this other stuff, but it's cool. The good Lord's in our favor, man. So I'm calling it that the rain's gonna stop by the time we get outside. So yeah, we're about to go in here and talk to the owner, and hopefully get to check out some amazing animals and see what this place is all about. Yay!
We got a friend right there already. Yay! Howdy, buddy. Howdy, cowboy. Ooh, that rain is cutting me up.
It's cold out here too.
Oh boy.
This rain is killing me. Not really. I love the rain. Rain's good for you, man. With the rain.
Okay. Hey.
Howdy.
Hello.
Howdy.
All right, I went inside to check in and everything. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. That's lit. I don't know what that is. Looks like little kangaroo foxes. Uh-huh. But anyway, I went inside to talk to the owner. I think it's the owner. And he's pretty much going to let me drive in here since it's raining. And we're going to go down to the sloth. We're gonna go down to the sloths and check out the sloths and whatnot, since that's inside, so that'll be dope. Here he goes right here. He's this is cool, this is cool. They might let me in. Boom, and just like that, we're about to drive on through. This is pretty cool. We got all types of stuff out here. It's raining. Ah, man. All types of cool stuff out here, though. Really, really dope. Got some big birds. Some big birds!
Oh, hey.
I love reptiles.
The reptile house is
right
there.
I saw it on the roof. You want to do part in here and do part over
there? Yeah.
You'll get plenty. You need about, what, 20 minutes worth?
Yeah, about 20 minutes or so, then I'll hit the road.
I don't know how long you'll take, but you just need about 20 minutes worth of airtime.
To be honest about, it'll be condensed into 3 minutes or so. So,
okay.
We'll talk about the sloths. We'll talk about a little about, well, for the sake
of trust thing.
Yeah, like she's with them all the time.
Mm-hmm. Oh, cool.
I don't see very well during the daytime. So that's like a huge thing.
She's like sniffing around, just open his mouth open, something drops in.
Well, she'll take phones away, and like she likes to play with stuff. So she'll take phones, she'll play people's hats. Anything you bring in this room, she's gonna be playing with that.
There she goes, trying to grab me.
She's about to like hook me.
Mine.
He doesn't.
Yeah, he's like just chilling.
He's a little more natural than she is. She's a kooky one.
Smack it. That's too funny.
Are these your first sloths you got to go around?
What's that?
Are these your first sloths you have like gotten to go around?
Is it?
this close and interact, like I've been close to them, but it's usually like, I think I've seen them at the zoo before and you can like pet their fur, but it's never like, it's coming over.
Right.
Is that more? Is that more? Can you give me more? This is not food, I promise. This is not food. Your nose is so runny. Yeah. If you hang upside down all day, yeah, it's gonna, the fluids are gonna come to your nose, bud. Oh, there you go.
He's
doing the food check. Is this object? So my snake's at home, like, I can't.
Everything to him. He likes everything pretty much done for him for the most part. He's very lazy. And it's cute to just watch him kind of nap on stuff. He's a cute eater. He always wants everybody over with his little snacking.
Right.
He's passive and really great. She's outgoing and loves to play and like all over the place.
He's like, store at the zucchini in his little leg.
He's like, I'll take this one too.
Sorry if I feed her?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. And when you hand them the foods too, you can give them pets at the back of the head. So, okay. With new people, giving them a piece of food actually indicates that there's a hand coming in there to touch. So that way they're aware of that happening because they can't really see that movement all the time happening there.
Right.
So, I always use this as a good way for my encounters when I'm bringing new people in with these guys and those are unfamiliars to them. It's always a good start point. It's a great way to build a bond with one of these guys too. The key to their heart is foods. They love their foods.
Nice. You're making a mess, buddy.
He may want some of this. Oh. They like to kind of go back and forth.
He's like, what's she eating? I want that.
Right? They're jealous.
Oh.
She may come and take it home.
Dalmatian love here. Is that the movie where they eat the spaghetti?
Right. Lady
in the Tramp. Lady in the Tramp, yeah.
She'll come and eat it right out of his mouth.
This is too cute.
So you can give him some more if you want. I can keep it going. They love it. They have four stomachs.
So four.
Yes.
Four so when they're pregnant, does she bulge at all, or?
Mm-hmm. So she'll start to show a little bit. Gotcha. Babies are only, you know, about 5-10 grams. Mm. They're not huge or anything like that. So she will show a little bit. The first indicator is aggression. So we'll start to see some more aggression happening during that time. She'll be cranky. And then he'll stay about the same because he'll have done his part and he'll just kick back, relax, and
Oh, I thought that was a real skunk.
Replace it right by our little ferrets since they're kind of, you know, in the same
family. Same family.
It started as a prank though, to scare the rest of us. My boss brought it in and
moved
around the park for a little while and somebody had the camera out and
that's too funny.
Trying to find us.
And is that a baby kangaroo?
Yes, that's Rudy Roo. He's 7 months old. He's the baby. Everybody comes to see. We even got a little diaper on him and everything, like a little baby.
Wow. You are too cute. Hey. Just like a dog.
Right? And they start the size of a jelly bean, and in 7 months, this is how babies grow.
Wow.
Yeah. Takes a while.
Nice little feet, too.
All right, little hoo feet, as I like to call them. They remind me of little hoo feet.
This is too funny. Look at the... Like a little puppy.
Mm-hmm. And then they got their weird little tail.
Oh, wow, it just pulls up. That's so cute. Hey. You know how to walk yet?
Yep, he knows how to hop. He just prefers the bag. They usually, when you put them out, let's see if they'll kind of come out real quick for him.
Got the diaper.
Oh, that's yeah. But usually 9 times out of 10, they'll walk right back into the bag. It's my favorite whenever they do.
Shot
him. There it is.
It'll just fall right in.
Pretty much.
Wow.
Let me just hang him.
Just hangs out in there all day.
You wouldn't even know.
Stick his little tail out.
And he'll poke his head up and out of there when he wants to like look at us and stuff.
I'm sure this spooks people out.
It does. They're like, that bag just moved. And they're like, what's in it? Well, let's take a look.
Take a look.
Because, you know, if it's slow, we
won't
just have him right out there and stuff, so.
Look at him, he is too funny.
He's sucking his toe.
Just like a dog, my dog does the same thing.
Oh, really?
Yes. Hey guys. Oh, sorry. Oh.
She's been here almost the entire time. She's been 10 years now.
Oh, so she's goated, really.
Yes, she knows how to let herself on in. But they know once they see like these little cups, they
it's
know
time
exactly
to go.
What it means.
Look at all of them. Oh, this is crazy.
I say, if you want to
yeah.
hand some out to them, can you need to record anything?
Mind taking that. Oh, no, oh, 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 don't attack me. Don't attack me. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry. Oh, I'm getting...
We'll drop that there. We'll drop that there. Okay. We'll drop that there. There you go. Right there. Listen. Right there.
There. They know what they like.
Oh, 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 oh. You guys are aggressive. Just don't bite my finger off. You might pour me somewhere in there.
Process. Get out of here.
Oh, 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 oh.
Wow. The first thing before anybody comes in here in the morning. They're just like, non-stop eating. Just eat, not eat. Like... That's where I was like, oh.
They say they're good, lawnmowers.
Yes. I personally have ghosts and they great cleaning out like the brush and stuff. They don't really care to touch the grass. They want the brush. And so they do great getting all of that.
Oh, look at you.
They've got that figured all out.
You're such a cutie.
Her baby over there. I actually had to help deliver her baby this year.
Oh wow.
It's the first time sometimes they get a little stuck. So we did a little delivery. But she did great and now you're back out. Your baby's about a week old now and awesome. It's hard to believe that one's full grown though and has a baby of its own.
Right. She looks pregnant now.
All the feed and the pay.
Right. A little big girl.
She digged it though. They're like a good tummy rub every now and then.
Right. She's like, I'm not going nowhere. Keep doing what you're doing. You're a cute one, mama.
Mm-hmm. She's one of my favorites.
Mm-hmm. So are these like dwarfs in a sense?
So she would be like, a Nigerian dwarf.
Gotcha.
She'd be more than Nigerian. She's more of a percent to that because of her size. Mm-hmm. But like Macy Grace is more of a pity.
Troublemaker.
Yeah, one, two. That's why I tucked the cup behind my back. I'm like, if they can't see the green, they don't know I have it.
I just know our brown shirts.
Right. And the animals do figure out, like, who's workers, who's not workers, like, based off of our shirts and stuff.
They're like, we know who we can finesse and who we can't.
Yeah.
One you can actually touch and pet. See how fluffy they are?
Him out for like the kids and he'll just sit
out there
and, like,
so
on
weird.
A bench.
Mm-hmm.
Let's him come up and play with him.
And there she goes.
Wet, but let's see this. Let's see. Here's some.
I like the new Chiquita. She'll bite.
Really?
Yeah.
Is she the yellow one?
I'll say she usually tries to get us anytime we get into the cage. So we could do Jackson and we
Trust me, I'm the same.
Once the stutter starts, I can't stop.
Yeah.
That is cool. Oh, he's a big guy.
Mm-hmm. But they're really, ooh. Okay, most of the time they're docile and everything.
It's okay, it's okay.
They're all wiggling.
Hi, buddy.
So I have a butterfly gama at home. And they have like that, like pissed off face. They're very docile, but like very flighty. Once you get them in the hand, like, they calm down. I call him Mr. Grumpy, though.
Yeah, that's
because he has that, like, Mr. Grumpy look.
Yeah.
You're
pretty, though. I like it when they kind of have a little bit of a grump to him. It gives
looks fierce.
Character.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, should I touch him? Should I not?
His color.
And then the tail is what I love the most.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. It's, like, very dinosaurish. You're like a toad, almost, from the front.
His teeth.
They're supposed to have a lot. So that way they can hold something more prickly, they can hold something a little more smooth.
Slimy, yeah.
Get into like the snakes.
How cool.
Everybody usually, this is our go-to one. We get him out to hold. And everybody freaks out because he's really big, but I'm like, actually your smaller snakes, they're like way more bitey. I found way worse luck with the smaller snakes.
Well, they say, you know, a snake, especially a small snake, is a noodle in a big world.
Mm-hmm. And our other small snakes varieties, like, they're considered more like your garbage disposal snakes. We're like, these guys are only wanting to really eat their rats and stuff. Making sure they're getting certain sizes and ratios and things like that. Because I've had people bring me ones bigger than him, and they're like, oh, it only eats a mouse, and it's, like, thin in bones. And I'm like, you're crazy. Mm-hmm. Brought a rat right in, and it ate it right off the bat.
Snacked on it.
We see all types of stuff.
That is awesome. You know, I love the girth on him.
Mm-hmm. That's chunky.
Big chunky.
I think he's our biggest one. Because we have a really young one over there. That one's maybe 2 years old. Well, we've had him for almost 3 years now, right? Yeah, wow. 2 months old for about 3 years. And then Tiny came around the same time as him, so we've had him about just as long. But he pretty much just sleeps all the time.
It's almost like someone took white paint and just like
splattered it.
Yeah.
That's such sweet snakes.
And we have the blue tongue skink here. Never seen one. No, never held one in person before.
It's definitely a different feeling whenever you touch them, like a snake. Mm-hmm.
Can I switch with you here?
Yep. So you're just gonna want to support like legs and things like that. He'll want to kind of just lie out on your arm. As long as those like feet are supported, he's not gonna be like climbing and crawling around and stuff. I don't know how you want me to like, if you want me to.
Oh yeah, no, that's cool. That's cool. Yeah, shit, buddy.
Surprisingly, for like such small little feet, they got some pretty good little claws on them.
Right.
But they're made to just, you know, drag along the desert floor. So then that way the coloration, like when he finishes this coming off, this is actually more of a red color. And so when that comes off, it's a deterrent. So they're made to look like a snake when they're going across the ground out there. And the tongue is also a deterrent as well. But he's not like bitey or anything like that. Like you could put your hand up and he licks your hands, things like that. Like the little kids love it because the tongue, you know, just poking them and stuff. Because every little kid likes to see what the tongues do on the animals. So you can definitely put your hand up there by him and he's totally chill with it.
Wow. And you got someone donated this?
Yes. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. He was a donation. He was already bigger.
Now I'm like, I'm the only one.
I would. They're really easy, like, take care of overall and, like, feed and everything. I mean, you don't really have to, like,
monitors at home.
That's what I thought you said. We had a Savannah and we just always have.
Yeah, he's pissy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We always did, like, tongue feeds, like, everything with ours because he was something else. Because what Owen had him, I think his name was Jotunheim or something like that.
Yeah.
I think that's what his name was.
Yeah, they have, I mean, I've seen some docile ones, but I think it's more so when they get older. So, like, mine is still like a little worm.
Right.
He hates life.
A lot of animals seem to be like that until they like age a certain so many years. It's like their season.
It's like, you know what? You're not going anywhere, owner.
Right. Like, I know you and all that.
This is so cool. You feel weird. It feels like hollow in the stomach.
Right. But yeah, they're very different. Very solid too. Like the tail doesn't bend like most of the other lizards and things.
But does it break?
Yes, it can break and it won't grow back.
Oh no.
So I know some of like the wild varieties of skinks do. Like something like we would have native here in Missouri, like the five lines, things like that. Mm. Their tails do break off and they do grow back. So we do have some that are indigenous here that are kind of similar to these guys, like the head structure and the scales and things, because we have some that are more like a copper color and the head's more of an orange, like a brighter orange. Mm-hmm. Not like here at the park, but like in Missouri. Walking out in the woods, like you'd see something almost similar to like him, just a different coloration and a little bit like shorter, but they're just as like chunky and they look kind of body wise like this and stuff.
Wow.
So it's very different. But everybody loves his little ear holes and stuff too. I always get asked, I'm like, what are those? And I'm like, his just ears.
His little ears, man.
Everybody's got ears.
Little ears. And what are they eating?
He likes like his greens. We do little bits of fruits for him. A lot of people like tend to feed. There's like also like cat food. Like they like certain types of canned cat foods.
Okay.
They like egg. We do like pinkies. Yeah. We do like the pinkies and things.
But yeah, so he always starts with like his veggies and stuff every day. And then like, you know, if we have any like little eggs or anything like that, we'll give him little eggs to munch on. And then I'll bring up, you know, Pinkies, things like that, and we'll do that. And then we have set days where we go through and everything gets like certain types of calcium, stuff like that. So we gotta make sure we hit those calcium supplements.
Right.
So we do those on set days so we don't get any calcium stones, things like that, and their little bellies.
Definitely.
Wow.
But,
all
kinds of stuff.
We'll put you back here.
So he pretty much just kind of like slides on down in there. His favorite place is his little sand spot.
He's like, wee! He's like flying.
All right. I just woke up, by the way. Okay. I didn't get a sloth. It was, you know. But I mean, it made you click, you know, and we had a great time. I will say, though, Critter Lane is an amazing, amazing, amazing place. You guys have got to check it out. If you ever visit St. Louis, it's just an hour, I think, south or west, one of the two. But Critter Lane Zoo, petting zoo, is A-OK in my book, A-plus rating, 100% rating, great staff. Amazing people, very educated. They love the animals. They take very, very good care of the animals. And you could just tell by, I could tell by my visit that they love what they do. And so it's always amazing to be around like-minded people who love animals and wanna, you know, take care of God's amazing creatures, man. And, you know, share that with the world through petting and, you know, education and getting up close and personal. This is my first time going to a petting zoo as an adult, so it had like another type of amazement to it, just to be able to get up close to animals that are normally considered to be wild and things of that nature. I actually ran out of footage, unfortunately. I ran out of storage, so I couldn't get the rest of the footage, but I was able to hang out with some emus. Got to pet an ostrich. I don't think you guys understand, like, ostriches can be like super, super mean. Emus can be, I've heard emus to be human eating. They can eat humans, but I don't know. I actually asked the question within the video, but again, the footage went out. So yeah, this is really cool. As you can see, there's a rocket behind me. Just gotta be in the vid, huh? What's up, bud? But listen, that's all I got, man. You guys need to check that out or check out a local petting zoo near you. Get up close and personal with these animals, man. You learn to get another love for these beautiful creatures. But yeah, without further ado, man, I love you guys. Be sure to tell someone you love them. Spread love, not hate. And I'll see you in the next one. Yee!